Ellie, is it your will? Now you're more than okay. Ellie Morgan, I'm back in action. Father. Son. Holy Spirit. Now have the second of the anointing. This is with the chrism, the oil of Christ. This marks out the children as a member of the Lord's people, ultimately sharing with all of us the responsibility to spread the love of God in our world. God the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ has freed you from sin and given you a new birth by the water and the Holy Spirit, welcomed you with his holy people. He now anoints you with the chrism of salvation. Christ was anointed priest and prophet and king, so may you live always as a member of the body, sharing everlasting life. Now that I ask on the spot, godparents to place the garment over the child. Garments are symbolic garments. The early church people went into the body of water, were baptized. They were given a new garment as a symbol of their new life in the Lord. Place the black garments on the children as the symbols of their new life in Christ. Charlie, Thomas, and Joseph, you have become new creations. Clothe yourselves in Christ. See in these white garments the outward sign of your Christian dignity. With your family and friends to help you by word and example, bring that dignity unstained into the everlasting life of heaven. We'd ask again one of godparents to light the candle from the Easter candle. The Easter candle is first lit in the church on Holy Saturday night. It's a symbol of Christ's resurrection and our hope for eternal life in Christ. And we light the baptismal candles from the Easter candle as a symbol that we believe these children now share that hope for eternal life because of the risen Lord. Parents and godparents, you seek this light of Christ. This light is entrusted to you, you kept from inviting. These children of yours have been enlightened by Christ, who grow always stronger in his light. And they keep the flame of faith alive in their lives. And the Lord promised may they go out to be with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. The Lord Jesus made the deaf hear and the dumb speak. May the Lord soon touch your ears to receive his word. Mouths to proclaim his faith to the praise and the glory of God the Father. My friends, these children have been reborn in baptism, and they are indeed children of God. In confirmation, they will receive the fullness of God's Spirit. In Holy Communion, they will share the banquet of Christ's sacrifice, calling God their Father in the midst of our church. In our spirit of unity in the Lord, let's join together in prayer for his children, their family, and prayers. That Jesus is ours. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. We close with some prayers of blessing. May God, the Almighty Father, who filled the world with joy by giving us his only Son, bless these newly baptized children. May they all grow to be more fully like Jesus Christ, our Lord. May Almighty God, who gives life, earth, and heaven, bless the parents of these children. They now thank God for the gift the Lord has given them. They always show that gratitude in action by loving and caring. And may Almighty God, who has given us all a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, generously bless all of us who are his faithful children. May we live always as God's people. And may God bless all here present with his peace. And may Almighty God bless and protect all of them. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We congratulate and welcome to the church our three newest members. I will fill up the holy water bottles and the water we use in baptism and give those to you, and then you're free to go back and take your picture and blow up the candles if you like. Thank you very much. We're free to put our envelopes.